Hello everyone, Alex here from warrenoffkeys.com, and in this video I'm going to show you how you can save per user data to a MongoDB server. Now it's important that you've watched the previous two videos. Those will show you how to create your local MongoDB server and also how to save per server settings, so each individual Discord server that your bot is installed in can have its own settings. So in this exact video, I'm going to show you how you can save a counter and count how many times a member has sent a message in any Discord server that your bot is installed in. This obviously isn't a very practical example. However, the same exact concepts I'm going to show you in this video can be applied to some type of coin system or leveling system, and you'll see many different Discord bots remember certain user information no matter which Discord server they're in. And so this is how, or rather this is one way of how they could do this. So to get started, if we look over here, I have already started my MongoDB server. This is something I cover in the previous two videos. And again, it's important that you watch those. The link to those will be in the video description down below. And so now what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a new schema. So in the last video, we created a welcome schema, and this will store some information. I'm essentially just going to make a new file here. This will be called messageCountSchema.js. And we are going to import mongoose. So constant mongoose equals require mongoose. And then we're going to create a constant called message count schema. And set this equal to mongoose.schema with a capital S. And then before we actually write the schema, we're just going to export this. So module.exports equals mongoose.model. We're going to pass in the actual name, which will be message-counts. This will be the name of the collection or the table. And then we want to pass in the actual schema, which is message count schema. So inside, we are going to store the user ID. This will be underscore ID. The type will be string, required will be true. And then we're going to store how many messages they have sent. So message count, type will be number, required will be true. Now we can save this, then we can close this, and we can close this, and I want to make a new file. And so we're going to call this message-counter.js. This is going to export a very basic function, which will have the client as the actual parameter. And then inside of our main file, we're going to import this. So constant message counter equals require message counter. And then we can run the function that we're exporting and pass in the client. We can now save and close this file. Going into message counter, we need to import our mongo.js file, which is just a utility that helps us connect to MongoDB. So we can say constant mongo equals require mongo. So now we want to actually create a listener. So we can say client.onMessage. And so whenever someone sends a message, this code will be ran. It'll call this function, which has message as the only argument. And here we can actually get the author. So we can destructure this, constant author equals message. And to make sure that this works, we can console log author. We can save this and we can run our bot with node index.js. Going into Discord, we can go to our tutorial channel and I can say hello. And it gives us some information right here. We see the ID, which is what we'll be using. We see my name and all the other information. So I can delete this. Now we want access to the actual ID, so we can destructure that as well. ID equals author. So now we have access to the unique ID. And if we look inside of our schema, if I open this, we see we need the ID and then the message count. So how we're going to do this is we're going to use a very specific MongoDB function called find one and update. So we have to import our schema first. So constant message count schema equals require. This is inside the schema folder and then it's right there. So before we actually use find one and update, we have to create a new mongoose connection so we can connect to our MongoDB database. So we can say await Mongo, and anytime we're using await, the function that we're inside of has to be asynchronous. So await Mongo, and this returns a promise, so we can use dot then, and we're going to have mongoose, which is going to be our actual connection. Now, similar to the last video, we always want to make sure we close our connection whenever we're done with it. So we're going to use try finally, and we can say mongoose.connection.close. Now, inside of this try statement, we want to actually try incrementing the specific value. So we could say await message count schema dot find one and update. Now the parameters will be first the identifier. So inside of here, we could say underscore ID is ID. That way we're saying update whichever one contains the actual author ID as the primary key. And the primary key in Mongo is going to be underscore ID. Now the second property, or second argument rather, is going to be the actual stuff to insert or update. And we're going to use a specific Mongo function here. We can say $inc for increment. And this is going to have the value of an object. And inside here, we are going to say message count will be 1. So this will increment everything that's listed inside of here. And so this is the key we're looking for, which is right here inside of our schema. And so this will increment message count by 1. At the end of this, we want to execute it, and we can run it with exec like this. And then we can save this. Going into our bot, we can restart it. We see an error. So I forgot that this is using await. And so this function here in the callback has to be asynchronous. So we can save that, and we can restart our bot again. We then see the client is ready. Going in, I can say hello. And then going into Mongo, if I refresh, we see that there's no actual collection here. So one thing I forgot to do is, as a third argument, we just say upsert is true. So if it does exist, then it'll update it. If it doesn't exist, it'll insert it. So if we save this, we can restart. We see the client is ready. Going back to Discord, we can say hello. And then going into MongoDB, if we click on refresh, we then see message counts. Clicking on this, we see my Discord user ID, and then we see the message count of 1. If I go back into Discord and I say test hello, so I sent 2 more messages, I can then click on refresh right here, and we see the message count is now 3. So because we're using my unique Discord ID, if I had this bot in a different Discord server and I sent a message, this would actually increment here as well. Now, this obviously isn't the most realistic example. It is very unlikely you're going to use this exact concept within your bot. However, the same concept was going to apply when it comes to storing per user data, no matter what feature you might implement. There are many different use cases for this. For example, you can save their specific level depending on how many messages they've sent in a specific Discord server, or you can save their level depending on any Discord server that runs your bot. You can write different games and store different information per user throughout multiple Discord servers, so it doesn't matter if they're playing in one Discord server or a different Discord server, their progress stays because it's saved to a global database. Obviously, there's many different implementations that this could be used with, but this is the basic concept. Thanks for watching this Discord.js tutorial. If you want to learn more about Discord.js, consider clicking on the playlist you see on your screen now. If you need help, feel free to leave a comment or ask in the Worn Off Keys Discord, which can be found in the video description.